Governments lie all the time. Well, not just the American government. It's just in the nature of governments. Well, they have to lie. And since they don't represent the people, and so since they act against the interests of the people, the only way they can hold power is if they lie to the people. People the truth, they wouldn't last very long.
Shore greeted with nothing but niceness. Sailing west in attempt to find golden spices. Dominated by the popes and frenzy for ISIS. The Catholic Church expelled Jews and claimed it was righteous. The first man to see land would get a reward and get a yearly pension for life, clearly from God. A young sailor saw land, said we isn't far. Columbus lied, said he saw it the evening before. They touched ground, they were greeted by the Arawak. Columbus had them locked up as prisoners in an hour flat. He wanted to find a source of gold and that was that. And when they thought that wasn't fair, then he stabbed they back. When there was no more gold, he took slaves instead and left 250,000 Indians in Haiti dead. The men died in mines, the women died at work. The children died from lack of milk and they died in the dirt. They were just taking advantage of a passive people. They were just being the savages of massive evil. That's the church work, that's the path of massive ego. That's the blood of Abraham being stabbed by the steeple. At 16, 19, they were patiently waiting for a ship to carry slaves that was changing the nation. The white man was a cannibal praying to Satan. Hatred, contempt, or pity, or patronization. That's the cornerstone everything racism based in. The African had a more advanced civilization. Black was slave, master was white, rationalization. 50 million dead, that's Western civilization. At first they appeared in the north, and they were helpless in the face of superior force. And all of them were chained together, they really was lost. Racism isn't natural, it's merely divorce. Before the slave trade, black was considered distasteful. By the Oxford Dictionary, I find it disgraceful. It's not a natural tendency to be bitter and hateful. It's an actual enemy of the critical staple. Slavery grew as the plantation system grew. The reason for that's kinda easily traceable. Society of helpless dependence was capable of saying fuck a slave master, you in slavery too. Seven slaves were put to death for murdering master. Fear of slave revolt had them developing faster. You a Cataline killer, an elegant bastard. I would burn the white man while smelling the ashes. From time to time, white man was part of the resistance. White indentured servants wanted no part of the system. King Philip's war showed that if people would listen, that they could maybe break the complex chain of oppression. Tyranny is tyranny, but that's a concession. But the women, they was treated like that of possession. Black women had it work cause they was abused. That's the white justification of Aryan blues. The next move was to dominate the Mexicans. James Polk dominated them like they was next to kin. He sent Colonel Cross to lot of them and let them in. 11 days later his skull was crushed, so message sent. We take nothing by conquest, that was the mantra. The military wasn't human, they were just monsters. Henry David Thoreau refused to pay his taxes. Denounced the Mexican war and got locked in shackles. The 20th century opened, anger re-emerged. Reality of ordinary life was being heard. Anarchists and feminists came from factory work. Communism, socialism seemed to be rebirth. War is the health of the state, is what Bourne said. And if you was born around that time, you was born dead. The Espionage Act had people confused, cause it was double talking, they didn't know how it'd be used. Supposedly it was an act against spying. Du Bois noted that was bullshit and they was lying. Charles Schenck was arrested in Philadelphia for printing and distributing leaflets cause they was helping you. He was indicted, tried and then found guilty, and spent 6 months in jail. Don't that sound silly? had his freedom taken away by his own nation. But there's a lesson, do not submit to intimidation. The act still exists today and the shit is real. Supposedly Kennedy tried to have that shit appealed. Eugene Debs did 10 years for no purpose. He obstructed the recruiting and enlistment service. The post office started taking mail privileges of magazines who printed anti-war sentiments. A socialist named Fairchild had it right. He said that they can shoot me, but they can't make me fight. They sentenced him to a year in jail, and that was reckless. 65,000 men, conscientious objectors. They were sent to army bases to work there. They were treated sadistically and were hurt there. They were strangled with a hemp rope till they collapsed. And officers punched their stomach and their lower back. A garden hose was placed on their face with a nozzle about 6 inches from them so they couldn't swallow. The war ended in 1918. The government was just trying to wipe the slate clean. Hemingway wrote Farewell to Arms. Dalton Trumbo wrote Johnny Got His Gun. The war was over, but they didn't learn their lesson. Twin tactics of control, reform and repression. The patriotic fervor of war had been invoked. That's why the country that you live in is a fucking joke. You cannot be neutral on a moving train. This is a story about the lies that your teacher told you. This is real, actual, factual. No lies in the whole record. If you don't believe me, look it up. I'm trying to share the shit that I learned with y'all. Due to knowledge, your government does not care about you. The people in power do not care about you. Understand that. Power to the people.
This is the last war. In World War I, they said, this is a war to end all wars. And then, not long after that, was World War II. And then soon, the United States was waging war in Korea and then in Vietnam. If you study history, what you learn is that wars are always accompanied by lies. Wars are always accompanied by deception.